Very good afternoon, all of you. On behalf of the Public Affairs Center, Bangalore, let me welcome you to this OTT local conference for South Asia. It's really an honor for me as the director of the Public Affairs Center to have such a distinguished panel of executive directors from different countries that comprise South Asia, each distinguished for the work that they are doing, and each think tank having contributed in considerable measure to the development of the respective countries. I also want to welcome the two observers. I'd fail in my duty if I didn't formally welcome everybody by name, so let me do that. We have Mr. Jayatilaka, Executive Director, SIPA Sri Lanka. We have Mr. Suleri from SDPI Pakistan. We have Asang from CDS Myanmar. Mr. Kanchan Dixit from ISET Nepal. We have Dr. Famida Khatun from CPD Bangladesh, Jai Asundi from C-Step Bangalore, and Nitin Pai from Takshashila. So very warm welcome to all of you. We also have a fair number of very distinguished participants, all eager to listen to the various executive directors who have gathered together for this conference. Before I begin, let me thank OTT and Enrique in particular for this opportunity. It's just the right time, I think, to shift focus from the global north to the global south, not least because considerable good work is being done by all those think tanks that have gathered together today in this local conference, as you will hear from each of them when they present their expert views. This conference is important to my mind for two reasons. First, the region as a whole, South Asia, we face common challenges, primarily the human development challenge. But more important is the reason that this gives us the opportunity to consider how we might collaborate together in a manner that actually will help the region grow and put us in the forefront of intellectual discourse that becomes influential, not just in South Asia, but indeed the rest of the world. For those of you who are not familiar with the Public Affairs Center, we are a not-for-profit think tank engaged in action research in India primarily, though we partner with other institutions to work outside India. We are 26 years old. We started as a social accountability organization. We pioneered social accountability tools. Indeed, we invented the citizen report card, which today is considered one of the important tools for eliciting data from consumers and clients. We have a sister organization called the Public Affairs Foundation, which specializes in training and capacity building. And Dr. Annapurna is the executive director of the PAF. I must thank her for all the arrangements that she made of bringing this superb panel together. We also have an important vertical called the Center for Open Data Research. CODR is the analytics arm of the PAC, and it engages primarily in the application of data science, artificial intelligence, machine learning techniques to development governance. And we have with us Mr. Thomas Jacob, who is the head of CODR. He's going to be listening very keenly to what is happening in the other countries in South Asia. And this is perhaps one area where the true potential for collaboration exists. Finally, before I conclude about PAC, we have a flagship project, a flagship product that we produce every year called the Public Affairs Index. It's a composite index that measures the quality of governance of the states in India. It has been produced for the last 6 years and has become a benchmark in assessing the quality of governance, public governance in India, accepted widely across Government of India, the states, and amongst academics and researchers. Let me now quickly come to the conference per se. And as my as in my role as moderator, it's relatively easier than that of all of you as expert panelists. What I would like to do is to just frame the what I believe should be the terms of the discourse. Essentially, questions that the panelists might like to ponder. The first is to ask the question of ourselves. When we say, you know, the pandemic has given rise to challenges and problems, and ask the question, what needs to change? I think the first question we need to ask is, where does the fifth estate, as it's dubbed, or civil society, get its legitimacy from? Short answer, we get our legitimacy from the grassroots, from the citizens, from the people. So how can we better connect and strengthen our roots in a manner that we are able to better articulate the problems of the public? This is something that we need to debate. Second, how can we frame evidence-based research in a manner that governments begin to use it in substantial measure? We have seen the work that each of us does has been adopted by government in part sometimes, but there is no institutional compelling arrangement that would enable government to draw insights, evidence-based insights from the work that you and I do. So how can we actually ensure that we frame our research in a manner that governments can use it for coherent public policy and for well-designed programmatic interventions to improve development outcomes? And the third question that I would reflect on and refer to the panel is an important one, especially in the context of the pandemic. How can we advance the adoption of science and technology, particularly the application of data science, that can help advance development strategy in South Asia? I think the low-hanging fruit have already been picked. Each of the countries in South Asia have made quite remarkable strides in their progress. We're all young countries in the region. And if you look back to the 70 odd years that we have been independent, I think each of us has made remarkable progress. Yet, the intractable problems that lie before us, populations, large populations and large geographies within our countries that appear to be falling behind in the development process. How can we ensure that we can apply science and technology and data science to understand their problems and find solutions to them? And finally, the last question, how might we collaborate as a collective in South Asia? Each of us brings to the table remarkable strengths, but we tend to work in silos. Just think of it this way. If we were to collaborate, bring our strengths together and create, you know, critical mass, actually generate a multiplier effect, I think we can do remarkable things together. I'll stop here. With this, I would like to now open the floor for the second part of the conference, namely looking ahead, what might be the two or three things that each of the participant organizations might look forward to do in the backdrop of the challenges and problems that have been discussed. Before I begin the round of discussions amongst all of you, I was just carrying out in my own head a sentiment analysis based on the speeches or the presentations that each of you made. And some of the terms that resonated in all your presentations were technology, data, capacity, climate change, justice. These were themes that resonated in every one of you. If you look at what we need to do, what needs to change as we move forward, I would flag three issues. One is clearly the pandemic has brought home to us the extent of inequality in our society. We talk of COVID appropriate behavior, but for a very large population in all our countries, it was quite simply life versus livelihood. It was not possible for many. For instance, let's say a slum dweller with 10 people living in one slum or in one hutment, to maintain social distance, to do masking or any of the other protocols. The second thing that has come out is the how gender has been pushed to the background. You know, the normal RCH treatment, the health system has been overwhelmed, and reproductive and child health, including normal immunization programs, have sort of been pushed to the background. There's been a rise in domestic violence. And most important, there's been a rise, and there is evidence to point to this, of common mental disorders, particularly depression and anxiety, and especially among adolescent girls and women. So this is something that we need to really take. And finally, the third thing is that the growing informalization of the labor market, in the absence of a comprehensive social security system, a fragmented healthcare, public healthcare system, to which is the only recourse that the disadvantaged and vulnerable populations have, and the great digital divide in education, because of which large numbers of rural children in India and elsewhere in South Asia have been deprived of education in the last 1.5 years. These are issues that we need to grapple with looking ahead. So let me invite each of you now to make brief comments on what you think you would like to do, one or two things based on the themes that we have discussed moving forward in the next, say, year or two. Thing I thought we could discuss of taking forward basis this conference. How many of you would be interested in partnering with us in establishing what I might in a preliminary way describe as a South Asia knowledge exchange, a digital exchange which we'll try to encourage sharing of knowledge on a digital platform. Essentially, it works exactly like any exchange would. There would be at one end the knowledge seeker and at another end the knowledge provider. And if, let's say, there has been a successful good practice or success story in Pakistan and that problem can be addressed in another country of South Asia, and somebody can come forward and say that this is something that we have tried, we have demonstrated proof of concept, we have scaled this solution, so you could perhaps sort it out. You know, so the idea of a knowledge exchange would actually be to see if we can address the problem of data as well as knowledge product sharing amongst the countries of South Asia. If you would like to, I would suggest all of you think about it and then respond to Dr. Annapurna, who will be the contact person for this. If there's enough traction and if there's enough interest amongst the participant think tanks, not just the panelists, but others who are participants, we'd be very happy to initiate the process of at least looking at what kinds of designs might work.